Hello students, welcome back. I Professor Pritesh Vibhute welcome you to the third session of Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering subject. In first session, I introduce you with the concept of Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering subject. What are the content of this particular subject? The corresponding course outcome, course objective and references. So in second section, I introduce you with the concept of DC circuit or content of unit number 1 known as DC circuit. What we are going to study in unit number 1, that I introduce you in the second session. Now in third session, I am going to start with the first point from our unit number 1, that is DC circuit, and that topic that I am going to discuss today is known as electrical energy and electrical power. Rather, we can say we are going to discuss about different electrical quantities in our today's session. So now, very first thing, topic that we are going to discuss is what is electrical energy and what is electrical power. But to understand that, we need to understand energy, definition of energy again. Energy is nothing but ability to do work. That is the simple definition, that is the ability to do any work. So ability to do any particular work is known as energy. And energy is further divided into two types of energy that we already discussed in first session, that is kinetic energy and potential energy. If energy is associated with that particular object, whenever that object is in a steady state, then it is known as a potential energy, like it is the one which is used in the case of hydroelectric power plant. And kinetic energy is the one that is associated with that particular object whenever that object is in moving state. For example, again in hydroelectric power plant, whenever water starts moving, it generates an electricity. So the motion of water is given to the motion of blades, which convert it into an electricity. So that is nothing but the kinetic energy of water is converted into electricity. So that is how energy is further divided into two types, kinetic energy and potential energy. Being more specific, electrical energy is a type of kinetic energy, because this particular energy, as name indicate, electrical. So this electric electric part of electrical indicate electrons, and CAL indicate particle. This CAL is taken from particle. So a particle known as electrons are in motion. Because of that particular motion, some type of energy is associated with those electrons, and that energy is known as kinetic energy. So that is the energy that we are going to study in the form of electrical energy. But again, energy is nothing but power into time. So first of all, we need to explore the formula of electrical power. Again, power is represented by a letter known as a P. So electrical power is given as P is equal to V into I, and unit of a power is watt. But again, there are two formulas related to power. P is equal to V into I, or it is also known as P is equal to V into I into cos phi, where phi indicate and phase difference between V and I. But try to understand, this first formula is associated with the DC, and this second formula is associated with AC. Means in case of alternating current, voltage and current may not be always in phase. In that case, cos phi will have some value, and that's why power is calculated like this. In fact, in both the cases, unit of power is watt. But again, you can see that unit of voltage is V, that is volt, and unit of current is A, that is nothing but ampere, and that's why it is sometime also known as a VA. The power is also measured in VA, that is volt ampere power. Now, these are the formulas for measuring a power, but let me tell you one important thing. In case of AC, if I put cos phi is equal to 1, when the cos phi will become 1? When your cos 0. So when your phi is equal to 0, cos phi is equal to 1. So whenever current and voltages are in phase, then that particular formula will become P is equal to V into I. And that is why in case of a DC circuit, formula for power is P is equal to V into I. There is no cos phi because voltage and current are always in phase, because there is no concept of a phase at all applicable in case of DC. So this is about a power. Then what is an energy? Energy is very simple, that is P into T. That is nothing but amount of a power per unit time. So if I put it over here, the formula of a power, that is nothing but VI into T. So this is a formula for energy. Again, the unit of energy is joule, or sometime it might be watt second or watt minute. You can see that unit of a power is watt and unit of a time is second. Sometime again, watt is also represented by VA, that is volt into current, that is nothing but volt ampere second. So sometime unit of energy can also be represented by VAS. In fact, all these three units are exactly same, that is joule, watt second and voltage ampere seconds. So, or volt ampere second. So these three are exactly identical or equal. So this is all about electrical energy and electrical power. So in next session, I will introduce you with different type of electrical component. Till then, stay connected. Goodbye. See you soon.